Welcome to Jung Tuition. I just saw some new experimental result published by AlphaPhoenix, in which he shown that the electrical current through the bulb could be measured once the battery is switched on. It would appear that this result is consistent with the claim made by Veritasians. He believed that the electrical energy can be instantly, almost at the speed of light, transferred into the bulb through the field. However, this is not the case. Here is my simple explanation. Here is experimental result. From this diagram, you can see that the measured current is represented by this red curve. As you can see, as far as in the microsecond timescale is concerned, the current can be measured almost instantaneously once you switch on the battery. And eventually, and after about 1 or 2 microseconds, and the steady state can be achieved as shown in this onset of the current two. And to be exact, the current one is about 200 microamp. So it's not insignificant. So how can we explain this phenomena, this experimental result? Here is a diagram. The two orange color will represent part of that parallel transmission lines. And here you can see that once you switch on the battery and the electron near the a cathode of battery will start to move. So here the electron are represented by these blue circle. Okay. I only pick up two electrons. One electron, electron one, is near the cathode of battery. Another, electron two, is near the bulb. So let's just consider what's going on. Once electron one is moving toward the right-hand side at a certain velocity V1, the magnetic field were formed. So if you use the right-hand rule, you can work out this blue circle, which would be the magnetic field around the wire. If you go further, you can actually work out the same magnetic field around the electron two inside a conductor wire on the other side of this circuit. So the fact that experimental observation shows that certain amount of current was observed, which implies that the current electron two must move towards the bulb. Now, how can we explain the movement of electron two? And if you just consider this electron is huge, like this one, you wouldn't be able to explain this phenomenon. However, we know that the size of electron is very small. So therefore, this diagram is not realistic. So if I just enlarge part of this conductor wire, you can see electron inside the conductor actually have freedoms to go all directions, 6 of them. Okay. Left, right, back, forward, backward, forward, upward or downward. So six directions for any electron to go. So if we just simply assume that those electrons at that moment are moving downward, so what would be the direction of Lorentz force? I'm sure you can work it out if you have studied high school physics. So these red arrow will represent exactly than Lorentz force acting on electron. As a result, electron will move, will be accelerated toward the electric bulb. So that is why. So this is a simple explanation of that observed current. Okay. So the current, when the current moves across the bulb, work is done. Therefore, to some degree, you can argue that electric bulb is on. Okay. Furthermore, but this is, although this same, this model seems, this explanation seems very simple, however, they can also provide some very interesting estimate. As I just mentioned before, you can consider that every electron has six directions to choose when they're doing the atom, when they're doing the atom thermal motion in the absence of external voltage. So the current, those current, the proportion of current moving downward will be very close to 1/6. So therefore, this is a simple result we can derive. In other words, the current measured before the onset of the steady state would be very close to 1/6 of the current in the steady state condition. In summary, this experimental result can be explained without invoking the crazy Poynting vector. I will stop here and see you next time. Please click like and subscribe so that I will provide more interesting video on this subject and other subject. Goodbye.